You've heard the story, shoppers running for cover during the shooting at the Independence Center this weekend.
But new tonight, we are hearing how police first responded. A recording of the police scanner calls just posted now online. Hear how it all unfolds.
We have a report of shots fired at Independence Center.
We're going to definitely need some crime scene tape down on the lower level outside of Sears.
The victim here is advising he was in a physical altercation with one of them.
One of the troopers just approached me and advised that they received a call. One of the shooters might be here in a gray hoodie and a blue ball cap somewhere behind the hospital.
And tonight, police have two people in custody, two people they say they are talking to. We also have video of one, possibly even both shooting victims, showing up at police headquarters. And Maria Antonia is there. She just got some new information from investigators. Maria?
Kelly, a brief update from police just within the past hour. And the first thing they said is if you come to Independence and commit a crime like this, you are going to get caught. Now, let's go to some video we got this afternoon. We want to show you. You will see a young man who was shot over the weekend. The young man, he walked in this afternoon. His girlfriend, we are told, was also injured, and that may be her you see with him. We are not showing you their faces because they are considered victims. Now, police say releasing pictures of two men we've been showing you on the news in connection with the shooting was helpful. They also say tips they got also helped. Now, we asked police if the victims were able to ID the two people they are talking to, and police also talked a bit about the two persons they have in custody right now.
I think they are people that have critical information that we need and that are pertinent to solving this case. But at this point in time, they're in the early stages of interviewing these two individuals. And so I would refrain from calling them suspects just yet.
Our sources indicate that the two victims in this case came here this afternoon. Did they identify them?
I can't comment on that. I don't know.
Now, today we also talked to the young man who was shot. He put us in touch with his attorney. They talked this afternoon, those two, and they tell us that he is doing well under the circumstances and that he is staying positive. That injured young man drove to police headquarters with his mom this afternoon, and she tells me he was shot in the upper right leg, as you saw in our video. He is recovering and was able to walk into police headquarters today. His mom also tells us her son's girlfriend, Kelly, is also doing okay. And that is what we've been able to gather here this afternoon in Independence. Back to you.
All right. Thank you for that update, Maria. Again, right now, Independence police have two people in custody, two people they are now talking to. Police say that they do have critical information to provide, but that they are not yet calling them suspects.